Okay, today I'm gonna be filming a weekly vlog. Okay, today's the 8th of June. I'm gonna be filming a vlog today, so yeah. It's Monday, starting the week afresh. Went to the process on Saturday, it was amazing. Like, it wasn't amazing that I had to be there, but it was amazing that we all came together in unity to fight for what's right. And if you disagree with those protests and you're like, oh, well, the middle of coronavirus, I have not left the house. I haven't left the house for supermarkets. The only time I've left the house is for that protest, other than dog walks. I don't come in contact with anyone because I go to a field. So on my part, I wasn't spreading anything. And there's a massive difference between the people that are going to parks with their friends and drinking, or people that are going to beaches with their family, versus people like me who have only left the house to go and fight for other people's rights. But yeah, it was the biggest civil rights movement ever. I'm so proud of myself. I went with my little sister, I'm so proud of her, with my friend Hope as well, also so proud of her. We're standing up for what's right. I will be doing a whole video on this, but right now I want to speak to more people about it. But I have a lot to say. If you follow both my accounts, Drew McCormick, and then that's my personal, and then my business account. It's not business, but you know what I mean. Tis Drew. So that's where I actually am a bit more cautious about what I post. But I've still been posting tons on both accounts because I have so much to say. I think what has been happening since the beginning of time is disgusting. The fact that it's still happening to this day is beyond me. Like, and people are moaning about protests. Do you not remember how the LGBTQ plus got their rights? Because this is how. So if you disagree with the protest but you're going to fucking Southend, then you need to go get your head checked, first of all. Secondly, I would just like to say they were peaceful protests. From everything I saw, they were peaceful. So before you come into my DMs attacking me, I can send you multiple videos of it being peaceful. Us chanting, us marching, everything like that. So yeah, I'm also gonna be doing a story time about the modeling agency, but I need you to make me do it because I'm scared, even though I know I can't get like any defamation stuff put on me because I screenshot everything, I have evidence for everything. So anyways, I really wanna do that. Regarding racism and just regarding general bullying in the modeling industry. So if you want to see that, comment down below and like message me and like force me to do it, please, because I need someone to be like, do it. I already had like tons of my friends and other people on Instagram tell me to, but I don't really need that like final push. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I'm gonna go make breakfast now. I'm just wearing Do You Even Sports bra, which I got for my birthday. And then these Calvin Klein men's boxers, which I bought myself because they're so comfy. So yeah, this is what I'm wearing. Oh, yeah. Tomorrow I'm gonna be dyeing my hair. I'll let you vote on Instagram, so you should follow me on Instagram, Tis Drew. But I feel like in every vlog I keep dyeing my hair. But it's a bit shit because it's not like as white anymore, so it doesn't come out as fully. So I bought darker colors. So I'm not gonna use the smoky something. I'm gonna use different ones because I don't want to waste that color. But look what came. So I'm gonna open this, like unbox it with you guys, and I might try things on. I don't actually remember what I ordered because for some reason ASOS is taking like 7 years to deliver items, so we shall see. It's wet. I didn't order this. I definitely didn't order this. That's cool though. Passion fruit. Yes. Okay. Because it was sunny and I don't have any like denim shorts because my mum's vintage ones have now shrunk in the wash. They still fit, but like they're now bummy and I hate the bummy shorts, hence me wearing these ones. Look. Do you know what I mean? It's just, it's not very comfortable. So I bought these. Let's have a look. Oh, they're so cute. So they're like paper bag because I like Meg and Grub style. I got these in a size 6 because I wanted them to be a size up because I really hate things being bummy. And also I don't trust ASOS sizing. But I will try these on. This is a dress that, this is the reason I did this order, because my mum wanted this dress. But it's weird because I did these in separate orders, so they must have put two and two together. I remember this. You know when you open things and it's showing things like what it is, that's when you know you have a shopping problem. Like there's something going on there. Oh my god, it feels so nice. Wow, okay. It's these little ASOS design tops sell out so fast. I'm sorry, this is so cute. I probably won't try that on because that requires me taking this off, because otherwise it will look stupid and it's, I can't be bothered. You know what I mean? Oh my god, they put, okay, so I've done three ASOS orders. One was for my mum and two for me, and they put them all together. That's so intuitive. I remember I did these all like weeks apart. So from Monkey, I bought this sarong. I remember I did all this while it was still really sunny, but this is so cute. Like this is so nice. So it's like a, you know, one of those like, those moments. So yeah, I have that too. Ooh, so many bloody plastic bags. Oh god. Okay, so this is another headscarf because I'm obsessed, but I can't like show you because hair. Oh, I can't try this on because my hair's up. I might try on tomorrow when I dye my hair. What a cute pick. I just ran out of storage, so I just deleted some old clips. But look at this bucket hat. That is so freaking cute. I'll show you like beauty bloggers do. Wow. It's always light, it was actually grey, but oh well. And then, so it's reversible. This is so cute. Oh my god. Oh, my belly just rumbled so much. I need to get this tag off. But yeah, how cute. I'm so hungry. I'm just starving. It's 12. I'm not eating yet. I normally eat my shit such that I don't wake up. Today I actually woke up at 9. Normally I wake up at 10. But if I wake up early, I actually make breakfast straight away. And then I bought this, which I don't actually, I don't like this. I don't know why I bought this. It was just really cheap. Oh, well, I'll be comfy. And then I also bought this little top. Oh, that just ties up at the front. That's cute. I like this. Right, I'm going to try the shorts on. Oh, these are a bit, oh my god. I should have got a size 4. Oh my god. No. Wait. How does Megan Grubb look nice in these? I feel like I've been bamboozled. I'm gonna go send them back right now. That is just... I have nothing, no words.
Same shorts, which is not usual.
I really wanted paper bag shorts as well. Yeah, so I just made breakfast. I'll talk you through it. So it's kind of like a what I eat in a day, because I wanted to film that. And I did film that and had a great lunch, great breakfast. Then for dinner I had two Kievs and a portion of fries, and I was like, everyone's gonna think I'm a weirdo because my lunch was like a picnic, so it wasn't healthy either.
Today I'm gonna be filming a what I eat in a day. Everything's vegan. It's all to kind of stay in shape, but I don't really diet because it's not really me. I've only just got up because I go to bed at like 3 and wake up at like 11, so I've not eaten yet and it's 1. I'm only just ready. I've just kind of been reading my new book, Louise O'Neill, asking for it. But yeah, I'm gonna show you what I eat. I'm gonna go get breakfast now, even though it's like 1, but still. Yeah, don't ask.
Okay, so this smoothie has a tangerine, a nectarine, an orange, what else? A peach, salted caramel, B&D protein, ice, and then this pineapple juice as well.
Why in a day to be vegan and also to maintain, so to have gains, keep abs, keep muscle, especially in isolation. And yeah, I might even try and throw in a workout, but again, I work out with my mom and my sisters, so it's a bit like, don't really want to, you know what I mean? But yeah, I'm gonna get you all vegan abs. I'm not getting you non-vegan ones. That's not fair.
I've taken my siblings for a little picnic. So this is going to be like my late lunch. So yeah, I'm having this vegetable samosa from Marks and Spencer's. I already preheated it. That's why it looks like an oily mess in the oven before we came. So going to have that. So we moved places because it wasn't that comfortable. And we had a walk and saw the horses and stuff. So we have chili, hummus, some crisps. These for my sister, not me, again for my siblings. This is mine because the rest of my siblings already ate and drank their drinks. And then we just have some donuts from the bakers. So yeah, this is my late lunch along with the samosas. We'll see what I'm having for dinner later. But yeah, so this is my breakfast. 25 grams of protein. The B&D, what was it? Salted caramel one, along with literally a whole pack of strawberries, like one of the big punnets, I think they're called. Yeah. About this much oat milk, and then the same amount for coconut milk, blended together with loads of ice. That's it. So normally I make smoothies, but this is a shake. We'll see how it is, okay? Taste test. I never make shakes because I think they're gross. Still not as good. No, I don't like it. I don't like it. No, I don't like it. Every time I do this. This is why I just have to add loads of fruit and have it as like a smoothie with loads of juice, because then I don't taste the powder. I might go get a custard donut. They're so good. Mm-mm-mm. But okay, it's actually not that bad. I lied. Okay, it's kind of bad, but we move. And now I'm gonna do my scrapbooking. But it's not scrapbooking, what is it? My dream journaling. So I'll show you that now. It's really good, it's really satisfying, and it's really therapeutic. So if you're feeling a bit like... So for all you black women that are feeling it the most right now, and you can't really get your head out of that cloud, I would really recommend doing this, especially right now. Like, I feel like everyone needs it, but especially you. And just go on like Pinterest or just anywhere where you find cool images, even Instagram. I was going on like people's Instagram accounts and screenshotting their pictures, and then I printed them all off and then put them in this diary that I got on Amazon. So I'll show you what I've done now, and you'll just be like, oh my god, she's obsessed with cottage core. But
yeah, I am.
So basically, yeah, so this is
some of the pictures that I've put. So basically it's just a little simple diary. I'm gonna fill like the other side as well, but I thought I'd just do one side of the page first, there's not glue everywhere, and just little pictures that I like and things that I want to do, or like future house vibes or future travel vibes, since right now we are all in lockdown doing nothing. I'm sorry, is that not just such a vibe? So yeah, as you can see, I colour coordinated it slightly so the things contrast off each other. But honestly, doesn't that make you so happy? This makes me so happy. Oh, this is a bit fucked. Oh well. But yeah. Honestly, it makes me so happy. So I've just had more pictures printed. And I'm going to add them. And I've got like spaces to fill in these. So like a lot of these are like half full because I couldn't find things to fit. Yeah, so now I'm gonna cut all of these out. I think I'm just gonna cut them out today, and I'll stick them tomorrow because it actually takes such a long time, and like this time I printed a lot more than I did before. Oh my god, there's so many. But yeah, I'll just show you a few. Is this not just such a vibe? It is, isn't it? Oh my god, I'm so jealous of them. But yeah, I just thought, and then also added like home interior that I like. Can you tell I like pink? And then I love this. I've wanted to copy this suit for a while now, and I forgot the picture, but then I found it on Pinterest, so I added it. And then also like hair, because I love changing my hair. Okay, it is now 2 o'clock. I'm hungry, so I just heated this up in the toaster with some hummus. This is the best hummus, and these are the best sitters. Me and my sister are gonna have lunch in here because I'm doing the little diary thing. Did I say hello? Mm-hmm. This bitch is eating a ham sandwich in my room. Vile. Absolutely gross. She's gonna say hello though. She wanted to be in it. Say hello then. She's so shy. She's not shy at all. I should catch her off guard. So you have to tell them what your name is.
My name is Russell.
And how old you are?
6.
Oh, how cute is that? I wish I was still 6. Actually, no, I don't. Because you're going to be 14 at some point, and that's such a horrible age. Can I picture her? Do you want to say anything? Is there anything you thought about today that you want to tell them?
I know what to say.
What do you want to say? Do you want to be like, hope you're staying safe during coronavirus? Mm-hmm. Say it then.
Hope you're being safe during the coronavirus.
Yay! You're so cute. Aww. You going to finish your lunch? Mm-hmm. What film should we put on? Okay, it's the end of the day. I'm gonna, well, it's not then, it's the end of the day. It's still light outside, but it is 7 o'clock. So I'm gonna do my nighttime routine. I know I've showed you in a video before, hello, doing that, but I don't think I've showed like in detail. So that's what I'm gonna do now. And I'm gonna do it with you guys. Just because I feel like there's so many vegan skincare routines that are all natural and stuff, and that's not really my outlook. I do believe in acids and chemicals and all that shit and parabens and stuff because they protect your things and make sure they don't go. I haven't cut myself then. I cut myself when I was opening Indian takeaway boxes last night. You can't see it, but yeah. They protect your things so they don't go out of date. Because out of date skincare on your skin is not good. So first thing I use to my first cleanse, I use this. Oh my god, yep, cool. I put my reusable cotton pad, which I put in the wash afterwards, on my hair. But yeah, I just do this. I'm just watching Sophia and Chintia. I literally sit like the Hunchback of Notre Dame. Oh my god. So yeah, I'm taking my makeup off. And look at that spot.
I don't wear makeup during quarantine, unless I'm like filming and stuff, and I don't wear a lot, like, so this is my whole face. I just wear concealer under my eyes and on my spots. So I have one spot here and one spot here. So yeah, that's what I do. I'm gonna play Sabine Chintzy while I'm sat here.
It's a bit like your cat finally showing you some appreciation.
So, Alan, I'd just like to say you've been doing an alright job of looking after me.
I know, I don't say it enough, but I like you.
It's got more.
Yeah, said it. Thanks. Don't make it awkward.
On it, so you can get it.
Feed your inner happiness with delicious Onken yogurts.
And that's when I just hold it over my eyes to try and melt the mascara, because I wear mascara. When I'm I'm gonna put on my look how rough I look now. I'm gonna put on my little ears, which I always wear. And then do my second cleanse, because I wore sunscreen today and makeup, and if you wore either of those, you should always double cleanse. So yeah. Okay, then for my second cleanse, I use this. Come on. I put 5 drops for the 5 sections of my face, and then I rub it for 60 seconds. But you do this with your face damp, so before I did it, I put my face under the sink for a bit so it was damp, hence why I used this. Always bring it down onto your neck. And then I go wash it off. And then I will tone and moisturize. I'm gonna do a face mask today, so I'm gonna do that with you guys. Oh, I look so gross. You know, these YouTubers that look unreal, and they're like, I look freaking so ugly right now. I actually do. Anyways, let's get on with the video. This spot is doing my head in. Wow, I'm really being abused right now. This is the toner I'm using right now, so I'm just gonna use that. And then once I've done this, I'm gonna do a face mask with you guys, because I'm just watching Nella Rose's new video. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. So I went downstairs and had dinner with the family. I had these little like lettuce wraps. I don't mean like wraps with lettuce in it, I mean like it was lettuce and then it had chilies, fake mints, so like vegan mints. Well, I didn't fart. I'm literally sat on a box. What else are having it? Loads of veg, like, yeah, stuff. So I had that, and then I had 2 custard donuts, maybe 3, and a whole Nomo chocolate bar. It's probably why my skin looks like this. So yeah, I'm gonna continue cutting out some photos and watching Nella's video. Face mask I'm using, it's really old, so before people were like, they're not cruelty free, I'm just finishing it, so it's actually a bit shit. I wouldn't even recommend. We watched Sitting in Limbo and it was amazing. I highly recommend everyone watches it. especially people with white parents who do not understand the movement. Oh my god, look at me. Parents don't understand the movement, I really, really recommend. Because obviously I'm white. Duh. And I'm getting a lot of young people messaging me asking how to go about the situation with their parents.
It's the other way around. Mm. It still needs to be some kind of balance.
I've grown, like, even on my time on YouTube, like, you guys know my mind changes all. Okay.
It's actually really bad. But I don't, like, because Hiram told me it's really bad, so I know it's really bad. Hiram is my favourite skincare YouTuber, if you didn't know. So I know it's not very good for you. However, I don't want to just not use it. So I just use it at night time. So I'm going to put my hair back. I will wash it tomorrow. I haven't washed it in like 2 days. How gross. Then what I do now that I'm so fresh-faced is... Oh, wait, I didn't show you it. Wait, let me put it on first. Okay, so... I think it's the mint. Cement tree lips. Whatever that means. A lip scrub. So I use that. And then this is what I actually look like when I'm not in good light. Now I'm gonna use this eye cream. Blah. Again, don't really like it. Just finishing it. I actually have a Sunday Riley one, which I really like. I left it at uni. I'm just gonna tell you the rest of my routine because I can't bother to do any more like talking through it. But yeah, I put this in morning and night on my tattoo to keep it looking fresh. This is an eyelash moisturizer thingy. I don't know the brand. It's just white. So, and then I put Cetaphil cream on my bun. What else do? I use Duac for my skin. Have since I was 14. It's really, really not good for my skin, but which is like benzoyl peroxide or something. So, and then I use a lip balm by Glossier. I'm just telling you because I can't bother to get up and show you. I'm just being so lazy. It's actually like 1 a.m. Almost. Sleep well, guys. Even though you're probably not watching this when you're going to bed, and if you are, sleep well.